Hey guys, it's Mike the Wrestling God speaking. You guys are watching All Wrestling. So, this video actually is going to be for my NXT TakeOver card grip predictions. Not card grip, TakeOver Blackpool 2. Like I said, I've been watching a lot of things at NXT UK. I've been seeing a lot of stuff. And my first prediction, I'm going to talk about it, is that I think Tyler Bate is going to be Walter for the UK title. Because why I say that is because Tyler Bate has changed since the first time he's won the title. Since the first time he won the title in the United Kingdom tournament. That's when he first started. 2016, he won it. And I just think that he's ready. He's part of the team. He's part of Mustache Mountain. Still protecting. I like Tyler Bate with Mustache Mountain video. And like I said, Walter's a great. He is a great wrestler. He's got that Andre the Giant appeal that I've said multiple times describing this guy. I'm hoping he goes NXT, and I'm hoping that he does show up to NXT at some point. But I kind of doubt it, because even if he does drop the title, I think he might go to NXT, or he might go to the main roster. He's going to do something. My second prediction about the NXT UK Tag Team Championships, I think Mark Andrews and Flash Webster, the Mod Father, I think they're going to regain the titles back. Because I do like really young veterans. I do like Zach Gibson and Drake. I do. And Andrew Drake. I like them. I do. I do like Grizzled Young Veterans. GYV. I do. I like them very much. I do like Imperium as well. The thing is, I don't think they're really going to have to keep, they're not going to really retain the titles, because really young veterans, and I've said this a lot, and I've said this so many times with them, is that their tag team style isn't like Undisputed Era, or Gallus, or any of the, or even Mark Andrews and Flash Morgan Webster. I specifically think that NXT UK, like I said, with Grizzly Young Veterans, they still need, I think they kind of still need to hone their skills, because the thing is, they're good, they're gifted, they have great tag team offense, the chemistry is great, but I feel like, because there's so many tag teams in the world that are in NXT UK and NXT, that the pool for it, like, the tag pool is, like, filled with everybody. And I just feel like now, you know, more than, like, Flash Morgan Webster, they do great. They have a great dynamic. I like how they do their own thing. I like how they're walking together. I like how their entrance is cool. Like, they know what they don't blame each other for losses. DAV would gain, they don't pander. And the thing is, it's like, I believe they're not going to do it. I really want to know what the tag team name is, but I think they don't even have a tag team name. Because I don't know. I don't know. And my third prediction about the women's title match, I think Toni Storm is going to beat Kylie Rae. I think because she's been having a lot of losing streaks lately. And I'm not just talking about, like, I do want Zaya Brookside to become champion. I do want a couple of people to become champion, like Piper Niven. I do want her to become it. But I just think that Piper Niven isn't bad. She's a really gifted wrestler. And I like that she's a really gifted wrestler. I just think that now they're putting her in the picture, and it's changed since last year and the year before, that it's kind of a big thing. So it's kind of like, she's kind of the wild card in this situation. Similar to how Candice LeRae is the wild card in the NXT division, the women's division with Rhea Ripley, with Io and Rhea and all the rest of them. She's the wild card because she might eventually become women's champion. And I'm just thinking in the back of my mind that three women want that title, and that title has changed hands since Rhea. And Rhea, funny thing is, the thing is, Tony wants to do something in NXT that's never been done. But it was done on the roster. And it was because of Becky Lynch. And if she becomes too, like, I was just saying, I think it should be title for title. why I say that, I really think Tony's going to take it, because that kind of Worlds Collide is a good pay-per-view to do it, and I think they really should do title for title, champion versus champion, winner takes all thing, because if Rhea does beat her, Rhea gets the UK title and the NXT title, that means she's on NXT. And the thing is, like, now, there's an opportunity to do that. There's an opportunity to bring everybody in. And my four prediction, guys, like I said, I apologize, I'm going to explain it more before I end the video, I'm going to explain it more. My four prediction, and I think, like I said, for UK, and I really want to see what is Cassius Ohno doing. I really want to see Jack Gallagher doing something on NXT as well. I don't know. I think they got him set up with somebody. I don't know who's his next opponent. I think it could be. I really want to know what Kenny Williams has been up to. And Noam Dar, because I haven't seen him. So I'm hoping the majority of the matches are going to be good. I think the card itself is going to be good. I think there's a lot of predictions going on. I really think Dallas is going to. Dallas, here's the thing about Dallas that I love. I love Mark Coffey. I love Wolfie. I love Joe Coffey. Basically, I don't hate them. And I'm going to explain this, guys, because Gallus is weird. Gallus is a tag team that's kind of similar to Imperium, where you have a female, you have an Eichner and you have a Bartel, but instead of an Eichner and a Bartel, you have a Coffee and a Wolfie. And I say this because it's so bad. It's not even bad. It's good that their Gallus is cool, and I like how they have their own faction. They're their own faction. They don't have to grow members. They don't have to do crazy things. And the thing is, like, okay, I used to give them a lot of crap because I wondered what they were going to do with them, because NXT UK doesn't really try to do anything with them. And I'm just, like, in this, like, not in this middle ground with them, I would say. I just feel like, because the card itself is going to be good, and I feel like Dallas needs something to kind of bring the fact, like, to kind of bring the fact that NXT is their playground. NXT UK is their playground. And I think Mark Coffey or Joe being UK champion as well, because I think him fighting Tyler Bate would be fine. That would kind of bring a rivalry for Cardiff, and I think that should work for the summer, because I think that should be a big thing. I think a lot of people don't see it like I do. A lot of people don't see it like I do. A lot of people don't see it like I do. I don't know. Because the thing is, I don't know about guys. I really don't know about Mark Coffey and Wolfgang winning, because it's like, it's not like they never won the title before, but they did. And the thing is, they did it in such a fashion. And I think Mark Andrews and Morgan Flash Webster are actually going to be able to do it, because they've known the style. They know how to beat them. They got quick. All they have to do is the speed to take them off their feet. And like I said, I'm going to do this for my fifth prediction as well. I think Tyler Bate is going to become the new NXT, the new UK, NXT UK champion, because I feel like he can do it, because he's done it before. And because he learned from his past and he's kind of developed a little bit more, he's not that young guy anymore. He's not that, you know, he's not that friendly. Like, he's still a friendly guy, but he's part of Mustache Mountain, though. And the thing is, when his partner got hurt and they beat him up, and you know, Imperium beat him up for that whole entire year, it was a really shaky year. And I think now, and I want Travis Banks at some point to keep me buzzed on, to become the NXT UK champion. I like the guy. I think he's a good guy. He's a good guy to have, and I think he's gonna be champion. I think Kenny Williams will be champion. I think anybody, even Mark Andrews, could be champion at some point as well. And I think Johnny Saint is ready to do it, and I think he's pulling the trigger on it, guys. I think he's pulling the trigger on, like, I really think he's pulling the trigger on Tyler Bate becoming champion, because, like I said, what Volta isn't bad. Imperium themselves are not bad. As a unit, they're unstoppable. And individually, as a tag team, they're unstoppable. And I've seen them do it. And it's the thing is that it's not really relative, but it's so relative that they've actually thought about doing what they want to do. And I just think that now at NXT, it's like at this point, you know, like I said, NXT UK changes just like NXT. There's going to be a paradigm shift with Tyler Bate being an NXT champion. There's going to be this big, it's this big feeling that we're there for. We're right in the mix of it. We're right in the thick of it where, like I said, guys, we're right in the thick of it where everything is going to change. Everything is going to change. Everything is going to flip. Everything is going to up and down. Like this year for NXT, for both NXT and NXT UK, it's a new era. It's a new era for everybody in the ranks to be getting a clean slate, to get everybody to win, to have titles, to have the titles actually mean more, and that's what it is about. Because like I said, Piper Niven could be women's, NXT Women's Champion. We don't know, because Piper Niven is fantastic. I've seen her. She's fantastic. I've seen Kylie Rae. I've seen her win. Xavier Woods introduced her up, up, down, down, like the first time she did, and she hasn't changed. And I think Toni Storm, and I've said this a lot about her, and I said it to when I first watched the first Takeover Black, when I said a long time ago when I made the first review of it, I said to you guys that Toni Storm is going to be the future. Like, Rhea's going to be the future of NXT, because Rhea has that undying spirit. She's only 23, and she got a long way to go. And this is what I'm talking about, where they're not using her, where they're not pushing the button, where they're using her and they're putting her in the title seat and they pulled the trigger and said, let's not screw her, let's make her a champion. Let's make her the champion. Let's make her the man. Let's make her the opposite thing. And that's what you got to look at Kaylee Ray. She came in and took that title and won. And most people don't think, like I said, guys, most people don't think about the like Blackpool. Like I said, this Blackpool, this NXT TakeOver, and I'm going to tell you guys, and I think in my honest opinion, because I'm giving you guys like a clear review of my mind, I think it's going to be a really stacked card. I think it's going to be really entertaining. I think the crowd is going to love it. I think that this match between Tyler Bate and Walter is going to be a big thing, because I'm saying this, why? Because I'm thinking in the back of my mind, like, NXT has no problems. NXT UK has no problems, just like NXT has no problems. And I think that they're trying to pull the trigger on some things. I think that everybody who's in this championship match with this women's title is ready to go. The odds are weird, but I like that they are, because anything can happen. That's the cardinal rule in WWE. Anything can happen to disrupt it. And like I said, I don't know what they're gonna do for like as the years go on, even with 2020, even with NXT as a whole, as a team, as a faction, as anything. I think, like I said, guys, I'm giving you guys a preview before. I got a couple more things to say before I end the video. Like I said, guys, just like I said, give me your thoughts on it. But like I said, I already got my picks. I really think Toni Storm is gonna win. I think that'd be really good momentum heading towards Clyde. I think Tyler Bate becoming the new UK champion is a really good way to head into towards Clyde as well. I think he should be in that. I think Tyler Bate should be in that. I think they need something. It's time for a change. It's time for a change. It's time for a change. I think it's time that Walter, I think he's got to give up the belt. Like I said, I think it's time for a change. I think Walter, being the guy that he is, it's time for a change. it's time. It's time for him to be him. It's time for him to go his own way. It's time for him to be. It's time for Travis Banks and Tyler Bates to become champion. I think he's learned from his past. This is gonna be his future. I think, like I said, guys, this is messed up before I end the video. I think it's time for Tony to become champion. I think Kylie Rae is learning, but I think she's gotten overconfident. I think Piper Niven is just the young upstart, just like everybody else. I think she's looking for an opportunity, just like Cameron Grimes and Damian Priest and Keith Lee wanted an opportunity, and he got the opportunity to be the number one contender for the North American Championship in NXT. I think it's time for I think it's time for a future change. I think it's time. I think it's time for a future shock, because you know what? I used to think, I'll be honest with you guys, I used to think that NXT UK would change. I thought maybe bringing all these guys together, bringing this company together was something that we could never do, but it's done. And like I said, I think Walter, being the guy that he is, Tyler B being the guy that he is, the tag team division is going to be on its head. The top guy in NXT has always got to have the belt. Either it's a tag team, either it's a singles competitor, either you're just a runner, young blood, it doesn't matter. But like I said, I think it's time for a change. I think everybody trying to get belts now is a good change for WWE, and did with AEW. I think it's time to give people what they want. Walter's a great guy. We don't hate him. It's just that him having that belt, if Tyler B takes it, that means he's going to take it to another height. He's going to take NXT UK to its heights. But like I said, guys, I think, this is my last part of it. I think Blackpool 2 is going to be a really good, it's going to be a really good takeover this year, I think all my predictions are going to come true. Like I said, if you guys, I am going to do a review, but I will probably do that, because it's on Sunday. I will probably do a review on Monday, like the day after, to kind of just to watch everything and kind of to break everything down, guys. But anyway, like, comment, subscribe. Peace.